never too late to admit when you're wrong. Turn a new leaf, see a new dawn. The time to decide has come and gone. Just give me a chance, we can carry on.
What's up, guys? Today we continue the misadventures of adult life, because yesterday I found out that I have a roof leak. So I've been trying to settle that since yesterday, trying to find a place that could come out and take a look. It's spring season, it's raining, so probably everybody's calling, and everybody's booked out till the end of the month, apparently. So thankfully it's not like a huge leak, it's a little leak, but we'll deal with that in a minute. Then last night, while we were doing some gameplay, this son of a bitch decided to crap out on me. And the power supply died. So, now that I have no power supply in my main rig, I have to go and get one. So, let's do that.
I think this is going to be the way to go, but let's check some options.
Doing the Raidmax, but all the reviews online say it's good, so let's hope for the best.
Don't let me down. Kind of gray out today. I don't know. I think I'm just going to go home and maybe try to make my shelf. I really do need to do that. Let's see what happens.
I feel like I fought all my life for this. This one part, this one third, I've always missed. No, just don't let it go. I started the fight, but now I'm losing. So, will I fall again? I'm scared of fights, yet it was me. We'll be right back. can't forgive, can't forget myself. The
really stupid moment when you realize you're late to your dentist appointment.
2 minutes late. Not quite that bad.
This is not the swankiest dentist waiting room. I don't know what is.
That I'm missing, it kills me inside. I need help, oh please give me back.
They tell you that you have another filling. So, or that you need another filling because you have another cavity. So now, I have a leak in my roof. I had to buy a new power supply, and I have another cavity. Seriously. Also, fluoride looks really weird when they first put it on. Feels weird, too. As you can see, it's still mid-paint job. And the kitchen is hella tarped up. But, as I mentioned earlier, we had to halt painting because I found this. Let's see if you can see that. Wow, it's right here. It's right here. Now, see, when I took the smoke detector from here, I found a spot like that. And I was like, oh, maybe like a bad paint job or something. But then I found this like a couple days later after I had primed the ceiling, which made me believe that there was actually water damage. And when Hottis went up into the crawl space, there definitely was water damage. So now we have to deal with that. So before we can paint, we gotta deal with the water damage. But in the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and open up this Raidmax power supply, install it. That'll be a separate video, but you know what? Actually, I'll do the unboxing here. I was like 2 seconds away from using the 70D, and then I realized this was gonna be my video on how to produce kind of a vlogger video with just your phone and free software. I'm actually gonna do this on my MacBook with iMovie, and I'll show you guys that as well. But let's go ahead and unbox this using just my phone. So, I don't know where my knife is. By the way, coolest, so much noise, right? Coolest trash can ever. I like it. This is a kick you thing usually, but push, it opens, throw. See what we got. I like this. This feels like an old school Lego box. Like, I feel like I'm opening a toy. Okay. Really, really nice packaging. Dude, I could use this as a tackle box. This is nice. I could use this. That's a rubber grommet of some sort, maybe for noise dampening. Yeah, this is a fully modular model, so we got some Velcro straps, the screws. Keep it fresh salt. It's not salt, kids. Do not eat that. It's not salt. It is not edible. Okay, so that's the top layer. We have a brand new power cord. More cables. I mean, pretty straightforward stuff. So I guess this is the semi-modular. I like that logo. How is that supposed to be looked at? It's this way. It's a snake. Python? Does it have a model series? Raidmax, high efficiency, 80 plus gold. I don't know what the snake has to do with it, but pretty sweet. I don't know, because it'll be the accelerometer. Ugh. This thing's pretty hefty. Okay, pretty well labeled for all intents and purposes. And
going to an 850-watt max from the now dead. Man, in comparison, this thing looks tiny. Hold on. Can we get an LED on this? No? Where's my flashlight? Where's my flashlight? There it is. Okay, you see it. It's tiny in comparison. Now let's install it in another video. But we'll keep doing this thing.
Oh, please give me back this one time, this one third. I'm sorry, I lost it. No, I let my weapons fall. I'm drowning in the fears, and now I know that I will fall again and let it go, but I can't stop to
Harris's video that he did for editing with free software on a PC. So I'm watching that right now. I haven't seen it. And then I'm going to finish this up. It's actually the second day. I still haven't installed this thing. I was working on my baseboards upstairs. I had to kind of invent a way to... Listen, the previous owners put a lot of work into this place. And if you can catch the sarcasm in that, it's supposed to be there. Anyway, I had to figure out a way to, like, cut an accent piece they put on the wall so I can fit my baseboards under it, because my baseboards are different than the ones they had. Yeah, so that's... I've started that process. I've started the baseboard process up in the master bedroom. Still trying to find a roofer to come out before the 31st to check out my roof. Thankfully, it's been dry the last couple days. Let's hope it stays that way.
The time is now. Now is the time. I'm on lunch. I get an hour, but I put a 45 minute timer on my phone so I can make sure I'm back on time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do that install video. In retrospect, I could have totally just ordered from Newegg and waited the 2 days, since it's been 2 days since this happened. Apparently it wasn't that big of a thing, but whatever. We have one. We have one that's in a sweet case, so I got to, you know, open it up for you guys. So let's install it.
Is not dead per se, but it did definitely get overtaxed, because as soon as I plug in both the 6 and the 8 pin for the graphics card, no power. So I will treat it as dead, I will recycle it, and I will be putting in the new one, of course, still, but I did just want to throw that in. That took a while. I have to go back to work, but to be continued.
This thing is, and I so rarely use it, about to make some chicken. It's late. I'm going to finish that video while this cooks, and we're going to hit it up with some southern chicken blend from Love That Spice in lovethatspice.com. They ship. It's delicious.
When I said I might have to do another coat of primer on the edges, there's definitely a color difference. Do that tomorrow. Last of the leftovers. Wow, the camera sees like light waves and stuff. I don't.
Crazy.
why doesn't he just, you know, call it a vlog and finish the stupid video and edit it and put it away and, you know, just be done for the night? Well, here's a problem. I need this space to edit because the MacBook is over there. I promise it's behind those guys. And that's not organized yet. So none of this is free space yet. So I need this space. Soon. I promise soon. So here's what happened. I was putting the computer back together with the old graphics card because I don't think I mentioned this last night. The new graphics card is dead. It's not 100% dead, but it's I've got blue lines display. It won't load into Windows and it gets very hot. So I'm going to drop it off in an Amazon locker right now to have it returned. And in the midst of putting the old stuff back together, this happened. You see that? Those are bent pins and the plastic broken off. So, like an idiot, I've gone ahead and broken my primary SSD. So I'm hoping to be able to put it back together to work temporarily until I can buy a new SSD. Which, I mean, while we're at it, might as well replace it with a terabyte, right? That's what I'm saying. Let's go on this drive.
Oh,
So, if you have an opportunity to use Amazon Locker, do so. Little segment, and this is just to increase the level of difficulty for myself. I will actually, can I set this up here? Will this work? Not too much spilled. Just like screws and stuff, nothing big. To increase the level of difficulty for myself, so I do some of the other kind of effects that I normally do with like pop-ups and stuff like that. I want to talk about four books that I've read recently, graphic novels. Shifter, from the people that did Anomaly. Anomaly, which I've had for like 3 years or 2 years that I still haven't read, but I bought their other two books at C2E2, Shifter and FTL, Faster Than Light. Both amazing reads. I really hope they do more Shifter books. I think this one is fantastic. Great universe they've created. FTL is an ongoing series. I love it. It speaks to me in a couple different ways. I really like Star Trek-y kind of things. So venturing out into the universe to try to kind of get to know other species and things like that, I'm really excited about that. I like that one a lot. Like I said, I haven't read Anomaly yet. I think those are the only two they had. Might be wrong, but those two right here, check out the links below. Also, I'm halfway through the
deluxe edition of Wayward Volume 1. Holy crap. Also, for anybody who hasn't read it, who thinks it's another... What is it called? The White Messiah thing. She is half Japanese. That is described in the first three panels, I believe, or first page or whatever. First two pages, actually. It's on the second page. So, the main character is half Japanese, half Irish. And that's about as much as I could tell you without giving anything away. It's a fantastic story. If you are not reading Wayward, please read Wayward. I want this to go on forever. Or at least until its natural conclusion. And, oh yeah, this. I just read this, and this is possibly, I don't usually review the way a book is put together, but this is one of my favorite storylines of all time. And this is probably the best put together graphic novel of a collection of other books that I've ever seen. Whoever did this needs to do this for every other storyline. Like, when I get the Onslaught books, if they're not this good, I will be pissed. Because this Zero Tolerance book is outstanding. There were a couple pieces that I wish they had included. Just a little, so a few asides. They did do the one intro, or the one, the like beginning. So the beginning of the one arc in the X-Men book, but it was at the last two or three pages of the previous issue. So they added that in, which I thought was fantastic. Just the way they put everything together. The order is not perfect. The order could have, I feel like some of the X-Men books could have been pushed up a little bit in the way it was presented. But they had these prose pages where it was just text, and it was like, hey, this is what's happening everywhere else, just so you're caught up as to why, like, this random Uncanny X-Men issue is here, and like what it references to in this one page that isn't to do with this specific storyline. Absolutely loved this book, and like I said, I want more books to be done this way. Marvel, please, please, please put out more books like this. If you don't have anyone to do it, I'll do it at the cheapest price you can possibly. I'll do it for minimum wage. I will curate those books for you. Oh my goodness, they're fantastic. Yeah, that's about it. So I've got everything up. So this is my additional, you know, difficulty level. I'm about to. Is it right here? I made the space because, as you know, the card is broken and I broke my hard drives. I think I should be able to use them still. I have a way around that. Anyway, I've got my space. I've got my coffee and external mouse because I refuse to edit with a trackpad. Let's do this. Appreciate you guys for watching. As always, Dalibor for T3G. See you next time.